بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. آئی ایم محمد ظفر اللہ اینڈ کورس ٹائٹل از انالیٹیکل کیمسٹری اینڈ ان دس لیکچر وی ول ڈسکس اباؤٹ واٹ از انوائرمنٹل سیمپلنگ اینڈ ایئر انالیسس اینڈ دس از اوور فسٹ لیکچر فور دا ایئر انالیسس. ناؤ واٹ از ایئر؟ ایئر is the general name for the mixture of gases that makes up the earth's atmosphere. This gas is primarily nitrogen 78% mixed with oxygen 21%, water vapors that are variable, argon 0.9%, carbon dioxide 0.04%, and trace gases. As you know that we apply certain pesticides, which may be herbicide, insecticides, bactericides, to remove pests. The remaining pesticides in air are contaminants. So they can be measured when we collect air sample and analysis is done with the air sample. So to check air contamination with pollutants, we often analyze and collect air samples.
The concept we will discuss in this lecture is what is environmental sampling, air sampling, and three types of air samplers that are mostly utilized. Number one is high volume samplers, number two, low volume samplers, and number three is personal samplers. Before start of air sampling, we will discuss about sampling and environmental sampling. Now, question is that what is sampling? Sampling is the process in chemistry of selecting units or specific components or specific specimen from a population of interest, so that by studying the sample, we may fairly generalize our results back to the population from which they were chosen. So a small amount of sample gives us information about the bag population of the sample. So in environmental sampling, we must collect representative samples of a small part of the environment in which we are interested and analyze these to provide information about the composition of the area. For example, it is obviously impossible to analyze all the water in a lake. So, portion of the water must be collected and analyzed to determine the true concentration of materials in the lake. Similarly, to study contamination around a leaking underground gasoline tank, numerous soil samples are needed to map the extent of the pollution. So, we must keep in mind that only a small amount of sample is collected from a vast heterogeneous area. It is important that the sample collected represents the environment as accurately as possible. Major decisions are based on the results of the analysis. The steps involved in environmental sampling are following, and these steps are important in environmental sampling. Number one step is development of a sampling plan, including where and when samples will be collected, and the number of samples required. Number two, selection of the sample, and number three is preservation of the sample during transportation and storage. So these three basic points are kept in mind while discussing environmental sampling. Number one, development of the sampling plan. Number two, selection of the sample. Number three, preservation of the sample during transportation and storage. Now, what is sampling plan? The importance of good sampling cannot be overstressed. The sample is the source of information about the environment. If it is not collected properly, if it does not represent the system we are trying to analyze, then all our careful laboratory work is useless. So care must be taken to avoid the introduction of bias or error. Sampling is done for monitoring purposes as well as for research. Data may be collected to monitor air and water effluents or to characterize pollutant level in environmental media like air, water, soil, or other biotechnology. The objective may be complying with regulatory requirements, identifying long and short term trends to detect accidental releases, or to develop a database or inventory of pollutant levels. Research may involve studying the spread and transport of pollutants or identifying pollutant exposures for humans and animals. It is important to design these studies scientifically so that they are cost effective and generate statistically significant information. So, three points are important during environmental sampling. Number one, development of the sampling plan. Number two, collection of the samples. And number three is preservation of the sample during transportation and storage. Now come to the air sample sampling. Air samples are collected by using any one of a number of commercially available sampling pumps. We use three of general categories of air samplers. Number one, high volume samplers. Number two, low volume samplers. And number three is personal samplers. Now come to the next slide. These different samplers, which are high volume, low volume, or personal samplers, can be categorized on the basis of volume. The difference between the high and low volume air sampler is the amount of air sampled. The high volume air sampler typically sample more than 1500 cubic meters of air over a 24-hour period, while low volume air samplers start only 24 meter cubes of air or less. Total suspended particulate matter monitoring measures the total amount of particles suspended in the atmosphere. Listen again, total suspended particulate matter monitoring measures the total amount of particles suspended in the air. TSP, or total suspended particulate matter samples, may also be used to determine levels of chemical elements and compounds in the particles which may pose a risk to human health. An instrument called a high volume air sampler is used to collect TSP samples. TSP stands for total suspended particulate matter. The high volume air samplers draw a large non-volume of air through a 3-way filter for 24 hours. After sampling, the filter is relayed and the difference in filter weight is the elastic particulate matter mass. Dividing mass by the volume of air sampled gives the concentration of total particulate, total suspended particulate. If required, the particulate matter retained on the filter is analyzed to determine the concentration of elements such as lead or other metals. Metals can also be monitored continuously using different instruments. The design of the air inlet means that a TSP high volume air sampler is unlikely to collect airborne particles with diameters greater than 100 micrometers in diameter. This type of sampling usually takes place at 6 days interval due to the need to manually change the filter. Now, high volume samplers have a high ratio of airflow to trapping medium. Trapping medium is that medium which absorbs or traps the suspended particulates and are used to measure low concentration of pesticides which may be parts per billion weight or less. Over a long period of time, 1 to 24 hours or sometimes maybe greater up to 6-7 hours. So high volume samplers have a high ratio of airflow to trapping medium and are used to measure low concentration of pesticides. Now come to the next slide. Low volume samplers have an intermediate ratio of airflow to trapping medium. Again, this is that trapping medium is a substance which traps suspended air particles and may be used to measure higher pesticide concentration 50 feet to parts per million weight over a shorter period of time. And in low volume samplers, exposure to the sample is less from less than 1 hour to 12 hours or sometimes maybe 4. So, low volume samplers have intermediate ratio of airflow to trapping medium and it is used to measure higher pesticide concentration in the sample. So, this slide explains the low volume samplers that are utilized in air sampling. Now come to the next slide. This slide discusses about the personal samplers. Now come to the personal samplers. Low volume personal samplers are pumped. Have a low ratio of airflow to trapping medium and are used for air monitoring or measuring workers' exposure at airflow of 5 liters per minute or less for pesticide concentration in the high PPM to low BPD range. with runtime from a few minutes to a hour or more. As you know that personal sampling is the preferred method to determine a worker's exposure. In this method, the air sample is collected within the breathing zone of worker. Personal samples ensure as far as possible that the air sample best represents the air inhaled by the worker. So, personal sample is preferred method to determine a worker exposure. As you know, there are two types of personal sampling system that are active samplers that mechanically move contaminated air through a collection medium. Number two, passive samplers that rely on the natural rather than mechanical forces to collect the sample. So there are two types of personal sampling system. Number one is active sampler and number two is passive sampler. Active sampler that mechanically move contaminated air through a collection medium, whereas passive sampler that rely on the natural mechanical forces to collect. These are not hard and fast rules. Field conditions often dictate which sampler is best. So, field conditions decide the sampler which is used in the sampling. All air samplers draw air through a glass or stainless steel cylinder containing a sampling medium capable of grasping the chemical of interest. So, there is a glass or stainless steel cylinder which contains sampling medium and has the ability to grab the chemical of interest. Now, come to the next slide. The various sampling media available consist of numerous sizes and types of solvent, resin, resins, charcoal, and filters. So these are the sampling media that may be resin, charcoal, or filter. These are used alone or in many combinations. Sampling cylinder for low volume and high volume can be prepared from component materials available from various vendors. As you know that a vendor or company offering something for sale, especially a trader industry. So we can say that a person that supply materials or samplers is called as vendor. As you know that personal sampling is divided into active and passive sampling. And other sample which is known as complex sample. Complex samples surveys involve the identification and data collection of a sample of population units. There are multiple stages or phases of identification and collection. So, there is a difference of random sampling and complex random sampling. A simple random sample is similar to the random sample. The difference between the two is that with a simple random sample, each object in the population has an equal chance of being chosen. With random sampling, each object does not necessarily have an equal chance of being chosen. So, this is the basic difference between random sampling, simple random sampling and complex random sampling. Now go to the next slide. All materials that will come into contact with samples are prepared by washing, double rinsing with deionized water, rinsing with a solvent, pesticides, spray, profile or ethyl alcohol, and filter. So all the materials that will come into contact with the samples are prepared by washing and rinsing, and will be solvents, may be pesticide sprayed, that may be profile or ethyl alcohol. And after that, we grind this. As we use pesticide term again and again, the question is that what is pesticides? Pesticides are substances that are used to control pests, including weeds. The term pesticides include all of the following, which are herbicides, insecticides, nematicides, or others. Pesticides can be grouped according to the type of pests which they kill. They may be insecticides which kill insects, they may be herbicides which kills the plants or herbs, the rodenticides which is called rodents, may be rat and mice, bactericides which kill bacteria, fungicides and larvicides. Fungicides for the dry and larvicides for the larva. So these are important for the growth of our cultivations or farms. But they are actually environmental pollutants and they can be determined by using the air samples. Now come to the next slide. A variety of pre-tagged solvent tubes designed for the use with the personal samplers are available through SKC Best. So pre-tagged solvent tubes are available that are designed to deploy with the personal samplers and are available commercially through the SKC Best Company. SKC Best Company is the premier supplier for all industrial hygiene, environmental and safety equipment on the best cost. Now come to the next slide. There is the different types of air samplers that are utilized. There is the on the left side of the diagram, high volume air sampler, which is used actually as flow control, which is razor jar, which pan, which contains gasping medium, and it is paired in air over sample or over desired component, and this is the flow control. This is the exhaust tube, and it is placed in between that area from where the sample is collected. And this is the low volume air sampler. Additional samplers, this is the razor tube which collects air sample at 15.5 meters in length. And high volume sampler is about 1 meter. So this is the air, different types of air samplers that are used in air sampling. High volume and low volume air samplers. Now come to the assignment analysis of any environmental sample on research articles for you. So each student search out different articles in which environmental sample is analyzed and different know that this sample which is used and how it works and what kind of information are obtained from the sample. So in this lesson, we'll discuss about the environmental sampling. After that, we'll discuss that in environmental sampling, there may be of soil sample or water sample or air sampling. So we started there about the air samples and for select the air samples, we discussed that there are three types of air samples that are high volume samples, low volume samples, and number three, personal low volume samples. And these types of samples are utilized in air sampling. That's all about the lecture, which is about air analysis and environmental sampling. That's all.